Hello everyone, welcome back to our discussions on the banking law, and today we are going to get ourselves equipped with the development of the banking in India. Then evolution of banking law, if we talks about, then this is something the oldest cycle we can have, that we are having traces of the same in our Vedic era, that is at the time of Rig Veda. It is written well within the era. Into that particular Vedas, it has been clearly mentioned that, written that, a sensible man should deposit his money with a person of good family, of good conduct, well acquainted with law, and having many relatives wealthy and honorable. That means hereby it's been focused that there should be a person. Definitely institution was not a concept at that point of time, so it was individualistic only. So the Veda has mentioned it very much clearly that a person should think of depositing his savings with a person who is of, first of all, it says that good family. That means the person who is having very sound background. Second one, good conduct. That is the character. The person himself is having the finest character. Then only he should be trusted upon. Then, well acquainted with law. Hereby the word niti has been used. That means the person who knows what is the niti, what is right, what is wrong, what is ethical. Then having many relatives wealthy and honorable. That means in case of default by that person, his relative or her relative will come up front and they will help. So relatives that who are wealthy and honorable, that means having their own respect in the society, then that fellow should be trusted on, and a person should deposit his or her savings with that particular person. Reference of this borrowing, lending can be traced even our two epic, that is of Ramayana and Mahabharata. That is the before century 700 and 1000, we talk about the time frame if it is in for general particularly. Then we are having a very oldest system of the banking, as we have discussed in the previous session, that it's been a Babylonian theory, or it's believed that it has started from then. So we are also equally or at par into that things. We are from, since Ramayana, Mahabharata or Rig Veda, we are having this thing already into our practice. If we talk about the other religious belief than Buddha and Mahavira, that is the Jainism and Buddhism, they also had written it in a negative manner. In what exactly they said, they denounced the practice of money lending, and according to them, money lending is a sin. Again, they were of opinion that if someone is having excess, then it's ethical responsibility, it's ethics, it's a moral responsibility that he or she should have the other one who is in need, and one cannot be traded on that particular situation. The situation matters, so they consider it as a sin. The second point, although Buddhists are having some other, although the period of Buddhists, that Brahmins and Kshatriyas started banking as business, and in this period bill of exchange got introduced, that is as a hundis. We all are very much aware about the concept of that Narsi Mehta ki hundi. That is again an ancient time framework where it's been a promissory note kind of thing, or bill of exchange kind of thing being used to practice. So that is also part and parcel of the banking system. So we are having traces of that too. The tradition from money lending to the banking appears to have taken place in 2nd or 3rd century. Second or third century. Right now we are in 21st century. So we can say that it's before centuries. Even we are having such particular system. But for returning, if we consider that the Kautilya in Arthashastra mentioned different rates of interest to be recovered from different class of person, which has been written in 4th century, Kautilya's Arthashastra, which is a very renowned book or well experienced person for economics or Rajniti, if we consider. Then he mentioned by this particular time frame, that is by 4th century, we had already developed the caste system. Caste system hereby not by birth, it's by work, by deeds. That is the Kshatriya, then we have Brahmins, then we have Kshudra, and the last one is the Vaishya. That is the person who performed the task accordingly shall be categorized. So here it's been mentioned that person should be charged interest according to the work he carried on. From 6th to 16th century, we are not actually, unfortunately, we are not having any such written exactly the piece of work, we can say that, not written, but it was very much there into practice, that can be sensed through the written, exactly the literature or monuments, the Dilwara Dera. the monument of Rajasthan, which actually having a note that on a definitely a piece of not on a piece of paper, but was there written or carved on the stones, where the they had mentioned the two brothers who actually engaged themselves into banking business, and from that particular revenue they generated, they funded for the building a particular famous temple, that is Dilwara Ka Dera. So this is something we are not actually having on a piece of paper, but we are having very much relevant evidence for accepting the same as a tradition. But after that, after 16th century, we had boosted up. During Mughal period, indigenous banking was at its prime, and there was hardly any particular village you will be finding that they don't have money lenders or shroffs. We even call that as a Jamindar system. What Jamindar used to do, they used to lend to the ones who are in need, and they used to maintain that Lal book, Lal Khata Vahi. That's a book they used to maintain, and they can charge interest whatever they want. We have heard so many stories about, and we even have our Bollywood movies on the scene. If we talk about the next period, then the period came of a Firoz Shah Kotla. Then bankers were they have a particular system of lending the large sum of money to the states. What exactly they used to do, the state used to pay it to the army, because that was the time where major of the battles fought for. So our state was always in lack of money, and even we are having this Maharana Pratap story at that point of time, that Veer Bhamasha has given money to the fighting against the particular threat at that point of time. So we do have traces of that system even. After that, when colonial period started, that is when the Britishers came, then 7th century, they found it reasonably very well important to establish the indigenous banking system, and that is why we started with all. That is when we started with our first structured form of banking system. What they did is they started with the three agency houses established by East India Company at the Bombay, Calcutta and Madras, at point of time Chennai. So they started with their own set of framework. Reason being, East India Company was now on a developing phase. The East India Company was exploring Indian territory, and they started establishing their business. So the first exclusive Bank of Hindustan was established in the year 1771 under the European direction, but unfortunately it collapsed in the year definitely after serving a substantial 50 years, that is 50 plus rather, 1832, because of the parent firm, that is the firm which actually under the European Union they established a particular firm, but unfortunately that firm died, and hence this particular bank even died. The General Bank of India, which came into existence in the year 1786, but again unfortunately it also collapsed in the 1786 itself. That means it couldn't even run for a whole year. If we talk about the law perspective, then the evolution of banking law in India, law of contract, torts and other branches of commercial and civil laws are already there, or already having a provisions related to banking within themselves. Indian banking laws are largely based on English law, as we know, because we have developed this during the colonial period. So we have majority of the things we have imported from English law only. And it is very initial stage that we had accepted. Hence, the first act we are having is the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881, which talks about how the instruments can be taken care of, what are the instruments, that is promissory note, bill of exchange. And it took almost 40 years to get it into practice. That means the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881 actually incorporated into the year 1840. 1840 to 1881, it took 41 years to get it implemented. Definitely the pros and cons are there, and that shall be we shall be learning that the same at the time of discussing the Negotiable Instrument Act 1881. The second act we had is the Bankers Book Evidence Act 1891. This act actually talks about which are the books banks should keep, what are the liability on the part of bank to maintain the records. After that, we are having the another act, that is Banking Regulations Act 1949. And then at that point of time, the Banking Companies Act 1949. What they did? They realized that we are already having the Companies Act 1930, and majority of the parts of the companies, Banking Companies Act 1949, were discussed into the Companies Act itself. How to start with the company, what would be the functions, how management will work, all was being covered under the Companies Act 1913. Then what they really need is that they started or they renamed this particular banking companies like 1949 into the Banking Regulations Act 1949, specifying only provisions related to the banking regulations. That is how the functions of the banking business will conduct. Then the on a later stage or in a very recent time frame, we are having Information Technology Act 2000, which exclusively talk about how banking system will talk. Again, Information Technology Act 2000 is replaced by the newer version of the Information Technology Act, which actually helps in managing business of the bank during the CBS time, that is core banking system. That was all about the banking system from Vedic period to the Information Technology Act. If you have any queries particular to this thing, then please feel free to connect on vidhishah, that is vidisha@lginstitutes.edu.in. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.